"We have," replied Ojo, as he and Unc entered the house. "We have come from a far lonelier place than this."
"A lonelier place? And in Munchkin Country?" she exclaimed. "Then it must be somewhere in the Blue Forest."
"It is, good Dame Margolotte."
"Dear me," she said, looking at the man, "you must be Uncle Nunkie, known as the Silent One." Then she looked at the boy. "And you must be Ojo the Unlucky," she added.
"Yes," said Unc.
"I never knew I was called the Unlucky," said Ojo soberly, "but it is really a good name for me." "Well," remarked the woman, as she bustled around the room and set the table and brought food from the cupboard, "you were unlucky to live all alone in that dismal forest, which is much worse than the forest around here. But perhaps your luck will change now you are away from it, if during your travels you can manage to lose that 'un' at the beginning of your name Unlucky. You will then become Ojo the Lucky, which will be a great improvement."
"How can I lose that 'un', Dame Margolotte?"
"I do not know how, but you must keep the matter in mind, and perhaps the chance will come to you," she replied. Ojo had never eaten such a fine meal in all his life. There was a savory stew, smoking hot, a dish of blue peas, a bowl of sweet milk of a delicate blue tint, and a blue pudding with blue plums in it. When the visitors had eaten heartily of this fare, the woman said to them, "Do you wish to see Dr. Pipt on business or for pleasure?"
Unc shook his head.
"We are traveling," replied Ojo, "and we stopped at your house just to rest and refresh ourselves. I do not think Unc Nunkie cares very much to see the famous crooked magician, but for my part, I am curious to look at such a great man." The woman seemed thoughtful.
"I remember that Unc Nunkie and my husband used to be friends many years ago," she said, "so perhaps they will be glad to meet again. The magician is very busy, as I said. But if you will promise not to disturb him, you may come into his workshop and watch him prepare a wonderful charm."